Okay, so today I'm going to be showing you how to make one of these little key fobs. And so what you'll need is one of these large lobster claws. They come in gold or silver. I've also seen them in a copper color. And then you take and cut four lengths of cord about 20 inches long. And one of the things that I normally do that just kind of helps is I use the back side of this little quarter measuring teaspoon. And just like if you're curling a ribbon, this kind of helps uncurl your cord. So I just kind of place my thumb over and just kind of give it a pull. I don't go all the way to the end because I like the end of the cord to be stiff to use it as the needle to load the beads. So we're going to start by taking the four cords and place it through the hole in the lobster claw. And then you're going to find the center. Give it a little pinch. And then place the lobster claw in the center, kind of hold it with your thumb. And then you're gonna spread out your cords. And then take the other side, and then what you'll do is you'll pick up one of the cords and see what's opposite it. So this particular cord that I'm pulling here is opposite of, you know, this side right here. So you'll place it opposing the other side. And the same thing here. You'll take this one and put it on the opposing side. And take your black, same thing, figure out which side is opposing. And same thing there. So now you have your lobster claw in the middle with your cords. You'll turn it over and just kind of make sure that your cords you know, are pretty much the same length, that you haven't pulled one too much. And if so, just, you know, adjust it by pulling on it just to center. So then all I do is I hold the lobster claw to give it the little bit of tension, and then do braid with no beads. And I do that for 12 turns. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 11, 12. Okay, and by doing 12, that kind of leaves you enough room to start dropping beads. I haven't loaded the beads on this one just because I wanted to save some time on the video. So I'm going to now move to one where I do have the beads loaded, and I did the same number of turns. So now I'm ready to start dropping the beads down. And they should, you know, they should fit if you did the 12. If you find that 12 was not enough, then just do a few more. It's not going to really change the look of it that much. And as you can see, while I'm doing this, I also use two discs at a time. I find that You can see, I find that it holds it more taut, and I also don't use a weight. I use just the tension of me pulling slightly on the lobster claw, and I also hold the disc on top of my hand as I'm doing that. That was just kind of how I was taught. I know some people do hold it this way with their thumb on the top, but I find that this just works for me, and that way I don't have to worry about weights and all that bother. So anyway, you would continue on adding your beads. I normally, with a key fob, I use 9 beads per cord. It seems to give it a nice length. And it doesn't, you know, it just seems to be a perfect amount of beads. So I'll just do a couple more here. And then basically when you get to the end of your beads, you will then do some braiding without beads again. So I'm going to again move on to one where I've already done that. I've braided the 9 beads in. And so then you'll just go in and remove your, you know, your little clips or whatever you're using for bead stoppers. And then you're going to braid with no beads for 8 times. So that's 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And then what I do is take the next 2 cords that would be the ones that you would be braiding with, and I lift them up. I tie an overhand knot. And again, making it a square knot, and then remove all your cords, and you will have this strangly little mess. So anyway, then just kind of take it, put the 8 cords together, make an overhand knot, and just kind of move the knot as close to the end of your braid as you can, and then I give each one an individual tug to make sure that the whole knot is nice and tight. Okay, and there you have it. And then what I normally do is I leave like a 2-inch tail, 1.5 inches to 2-inch tail. So you just cut off your ends, and what you're left with is a cute little key fob. And then you can just clip this on your key ring, or you can clip it to use it as a zipper pull, put it on your pocketbook, or put it on a sweatshirt, something to, you know, just to pull your zipper up and down. Or what I do is, this is how I create my templates for my kits, is I make a small little key fob like this. That way I don't have to braid the whole bracelet, and I can see whether or not it looks good. And then when I take a picture of this, the little segment is enough to show, you know, what beads are in, and it just saves some time that way. So anyway, I hope you enjoyed this video, and come back and see me again. Bye!